Hi everyone, and this is regarding computer architecture unit 4, memory and IO systems. So these are the topics we should cover: memory hierarchy, memory technologies, cache memory, measuring and improving cache performance, virtual memory, TLBs. And the next part is accessing I/O devices, interrupts, direct memory access, bus structures, bus operation, arbitration, interface circuits, and finally USB. In today's session, we shall discuss about the topics memory hierarchy, memory technologies, cache memory, measuring and improving cache performance, and virtual memory and TLB we will see in the next session. Memory hierarchy. So before going for the discussion of memory hierarchy, let us discuss about the term memory unit. So here the memory unit, it is the collection of all storage units and they are put together to act as a common memory. And here the data will be stored in the form of binary, and we can see it is in the form of bits, zeros and ones. So memory can be classified into two cases in general. One is volatile memory and another one is non-volatile memory. In the case of volatile memory, the data will be there in volatile memory through the time the volatile memory is supplied with power. If the power is switched off, then the data in the volatile memory will be lost. And in the case of non-volatile memory, the case is entirely different. The data will be permanent throughout, whether the power is switched on or switched off, that won't be matter. Data is going to be there in the memory throughout. The auxiliary memory, magnetic disks, magnetic tapes, these can be called as secondary memory or auxiliary memories. So these are all some added memories, like memory cards in the case of a smartphone, whereas in the case of processor it will be magnetic disks and magnetic tapes. So these memories will be communicated, or these memories will be in effect only through the main memory. So for that case there will be some IO processor. Through that IO processor, main memory can access the magnetic tapes and magnetic disks, and through the main memory CPU can make use of that those data from magnetic tapes and magnetic disks. So no direct way, indirectly through main memory. And regarding memory hierarchy, even we want to discuss about the terms like how fast, how slow, and how large or smaller. So here auxiliary memory will be slow because they are not in direct connection. Then the main memory, it will be somewhat fast, whereas cache memory, it is very smaller and it is very nearest to CPU. So this cache memory will be very fast. So that is the access time ratio with respect to main memory will be 1:7, whereas the auxiliary memory, they are 1000 times, their access time will be 1000 times with respect to main memory. Then regarding auxiliary memory, when there is overflow from the main memory or there is not sufficient memory space in the main memory, in such a case auxiliary memory will be taken into effect. That is, the data in main memory will be transferred to auxiliary memory, and in certain cases the data will be in auxiliary memory and they will be transferred to CPU for processing purpose through main memory. And the next topic is memory access methods and technologies. So here how the memory is going to be considered in the processor is, So memories will be considered as a number of memory locations, and those locations will be provided with some address value. So the processor can access those memory with the help of this address, either reading the data or writing data onto that memory location. So for that, there are some access methods. The first one is random access. In the case of random access, as memories they are having some address with respect to the memory location, with the help of this address, by making use of this address decoding, that memories can be accessed. So there is no need of any order in a way the processor should access the memory. So it can be accessed randomly, so random access. And the next one is sequential access. In the case of sequential access, there should be a specific order. So the first the memory, say for example 2001, if it is the address, so that address should be accessed first from the memory, then 2002, then 2003, like that it should go. So sequential order. Then the case of direct access. In the case of direct access, there is nothing like address space, sequential way of accessing and all. Whereas the data will be stored directly onto a track, so that specific track will have separate read and write head. Separately it can be read and write. So direct access. Then regarding memory types, already we have discussed the main memory in the hierarchy itself. But in detail, let us see which thing we will be calling it as main memory. In the case of a computer, the main memory is purely RAM and ROM. And in the with respect to RAM and ROM, RAM will take a majority role. So random access memory, it can be of three types here: DRAM, SRAM, and NVRAM. Dynamic RAM. So dynamic RAM will be having capacitors and transistors as main part, and it will have the refreshing rate as 10 to 100 milliseconds. So every 10 to 100 milliseconds, the data can be accessed. And even it is slower and cheaper than SRAM. With respect to SRAM, it is very cheaper, because in the case of static RAM, SRAM, you can see 6 transistors are needed to form a 1-bit memory. And in the case of static RAM, the data can be retained until the power is switched off. So overcoming the disadvantage of this SRAM, that is the data will be retaining only when the power is on. So we are going for the non-volatile RAM with respect to SRAM. So non-volatile RAM, say for example flash memory, even though the power gets switched off, the data will be there in the memory. That is flash memory is an example for non-volatile RAM. And regarding the second type, ROM, with respect to main memory, so read-only memory, it is also non-volatile, it is permanent. And the application of ROM is bootstrap loader programming will be there in the ROM. That is booting in the case of OS, when the system gets turned on for the purpose of booting, the data in the ROM will be run again. And ROM can be categorized as PROM, EPROM, WPROM, so programmable ROM, erasable PROM, electrically erasable PROM. So programmable ROM, it is only programmed. Erasable program, the data in the ROM can be erased, and the advanced level, electrically it can be erased, the next case. And regarding auxiliary memory, devices that will be used for backup purposes. Auxiliary memory, it is usually for backup purposes. I told you already, if there is a number of data in the main memory, if the main memory is in a position to lose the free space, those data can be transferred to these auxiliary memory. Example, magnetic disks and tapes, then magnetic drums, magnetic bubble memory, and optical discs will also be under this category, auxiliary memory. And already we had said that it is not directly accessible to the CPU, only through the I/O processor and the main memory, this auxiliary memory can be accessed.